In this video, we're gonna be figuring out whether you need a traditional webcam anymore, or can you make do with just your smartphone. This is the Razer Kiyo Pro, which is a streamer certified webcam, and we're putting it head to head against the Mi 11 and the iPhone mini 12 to figure out whether a smartphone can compete with a webcam. Keep watching to find out, and let's get started. Now, the point of this video was to figure out, are webcams even useful anymore? Because smartphones can do pretty much anything. There's so many applications out there that allow you to transform your smartphone into a webcam using Wi-Fi or even tethered using USB.
The webcam, like I said, we're using is the Razer Kiyo Pro. So I'm going to tell you some of the main differences you will have with this against a regular smartphone. The Razer webcam is capable of doing uncompressed 1080p at 60fps, while if you're using a mobile smartphone application that allows it to use it as a webcam, you're generally restricted to 720p in recording. In the free version, you can pay for the paid version with 1080p and a lot more settings. The Razer does come with HDR enabled, but you do need Synapse to turn it on and off. You get adjustable FOV with it, while for the smartphone, obviously you get multiple lenses, but to use them, you'd mostly have to pay for the paid version of the app. Lastly, the Razer needs to be connected using Type-C cable, obviously, but with smartphones, you can use it both tethered using a cable, or you can use it wirelessly, which both work surprisingly really well. Majority of the tests in this video are done using wireless for the smartphone.
Compared to the previous version that used to have a ring light on there, this one doesn't have that anymore. It's got a tripod thread at the bottom, so you can easily mount it to one of those Gorilla Pods or whatever you want. The Razer allows you to have a microphone support as well, so you can use the microphone on board, which works really well. Overall, I'm really happy with the build quality on this. The FOV would have been a real fun to try out. Unfortunately, it's not present on a Mac, which is what I'm using here at home. Anyone who has a Windows can vouch for how good this application is. It gives you so much more control, as well as controlling things that are super important. But overall, you need the Synapse application to be able to control everything like HDR and all of that stuff. Just for the sake of making this a full sort of review, check out some links in the description that are going to show you the Synapse application and how you can really customize field of view, HDR control, and all of that. We're going to link some of the best reviews we find in the description underneath. But honestly, if you're planning to buy the Razer, just make sure you're using a Windows and not a Mac so that you have the support for that field of view control, HDR control, resolution, and actually tweaking and color correcting your image. Now, for a lot of these tests, I put the footage side by side for both the Razer camera as well as the smartphone on the display. And as you can see, the performance, the quality of them is very comparable. The Razer does up to 1080p in 60fps, but these applications can limit it to 720p for the mobile recording. And when you scale it down that small on the image, it doesn't really make much of a difference because it's already smaller. But to be honest, for me, with the 720, I got pretty decent performance. There were no issues whatsoever in sharpness or the color reproduction. We did it in low light situations. We did it in direct light situations. We did it with backlight situations to test out the HDR performance. Obviously, this isn't a 100% guaranteed thing because we didn't have the Razer Synapse app, so we really couldn't tweak it as much, but it was kind of the same with the smartphone. We didn't tweak anything. It was just using the application as you connect it. With the Mi 11 especially, I was able to get nice depth of field. The low light performance was really good, surprisingly, and the autofocus worked even better than the Razer dedicated webcam in some situations. So using both of these, I did a little bit of a gameplay test using the PS4. Obviously, terrible frame rate. You guys probably saw that. But if you have a proper streaming setup and you're planning to stream, it's obviously going to be a lot better. Using your smartphone even to stream, I didn't expect it to be this good, especially using it wireless. I thought there would be a lot of latency issues, a lot of stuttering issues. We had none of that whatsoever. Everything was very streamlined, almost exactly the same as the Razer. In some situations, even the Razer was lagging when it was wired, as opposed to the smartphone when it was completely wireless. So that's one advantage that the mobile phone has over the Razer, that you can use it wireless using IP address. Obviously, that's one of the biggest advantages of using a webcam. The sole purpose of it is to be a webcam, and you don't have to worry about getting in calls or whatever. So obviously, if I put it on airplane mode, I won't get notifications or disturbed, but at the same time, I just can't do anything else with my phone, which can be a little bit disappointing. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty doable. That's one of the cons, I guess you could say. So if you're using this and you're planning to stream for hours, you can't really receive calls, you can't text, you can't do any of that stuff because it's going to just sit there for a bunch of hours, just constantly being your streamer cam, or if you're recording stuff. If you're someone who just got into streaming and you're thinking, okay, I need a webcam and I need to invest a lot of money in one, you don't really need to because your smartphone can actually do that. So get started with your smartphone to get into streaming, and then you can figure it out later once you start earning or whatever to invest in a better camera. So all in all, here's what I think. The Razer Kiyo Pro is a great product for people who have already established themselves as streamers, want to take it to the next level, get that uncompressed 1080p at 60fps, great control on your FOV, great control on the image overall, you get HDR performance that is actually exceptionally good. The autofocus, I wouldn't say is the best, but it's pretty good for a webcam. But if you're someone who is looking to get into it, into streaming, I mean, or content creation, but you don't want to spend a lot of money on a DSLR or a webcam, your smartphone is definitely good enough. That's what this whole video is supposed to be. Pretty much everything is possible with a smartphone, which is really awesome that we're living in this generation. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, a like would be appreciated. If you want to see more content like this, where we break different things down from different segments, let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you again in the next video. Until then,